So one of the questions that I get often, especially around the mRNA vaccines that have been out for a while, is whether or not the fact that these vaccines are based on RNA, which is a genetic code for the spike protein of the virus, the question is whether or not this can actually get into our own human genome and change our DNA forever and cause illnesses such as cancer or changes in stem cells, things like that. The answer is no. For the messenger RNA, it is a very unstable molecule. It is produced in the lab from a sequence. It's not being extracted from any other living organism overall, but it's being produced in the lab following the sequence, and then it's coated in fat molecules. And fat molecules do a couple of things. It helps to stabilize the molecule, but then it also, once it gets in our bodies, it helps the mRNA get into the cells, which is where it needs to be in order to have the protein made. And viruses need human cells to make their proteins to replicate. So when this mRNA from the vaccine gets into the human cell, it sort of takes over the human machinery and cranks out these bits of spike protein that are coded for by the RNA.
And can I interject that that only happens locally in the few cells right where the vaccine was injected?
Correct. Because, and the mRNA does not stay around a long time. There's just not the equipment in the cell to keep it stable. And it does not get into the nucleus, which is where our DNA, our genome lives. So yes, it's important to know that it really kind of gets into our arms, gets into those local cells, hangs around enough for these proteins to start being made, and then the proteins get out into the rest of the body and our immune system starts cranking out.
I got this analogy from my immunologist friend, and I love it, so I'm going to pitch it here. So the mRNA, you can think of it as your DNA has all the instructions to make you, right? To make all of the parts of you. And you can think of this, and your DNA normally would make messenger RNA, which is instructions to make proteins, specific proteins. In this case, we're injecting an mRNA that has the instructions to make that protein. So my immunologist friend said it's kind of like the mRNA is the instruction manual to build a piece of IKEA furniture. And you know, what we've done is the IKEA factory normally prints those instruction manuals, and then people, you know, you go and build your piece of furniture according to the instructions. But in this case, we've kind of slipped some instructions into the factory, and our cells are going to temporarily make this other piece of furniture.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Instruction manual. I'll have to remember that. That's great.